Vala. The torments of love and jealousy in the death and judgment of Albion the ancient man. A dream of nine nights. The four Zoas. By William Blake. Podcast 9 of 9. Night the ninth and the last judgment. And Los and Enitherman builded Jerusalem weeping over the sepulchre and over the crucified body, which to their phantom eyes appeared still in the sepulchre. But Jesus stood beside them in the spirit, separating their spirit from their body, terrified at non-existence. For such they deemed the death of the body. Los his vegetable hands outstretched, his right hand branching out in fibrous strength, seized the sun. His left hand like dark roots covered the moon and tore them down, cracking the heavens across from immense to immense. Then fell the fires of eternity with loud and shrill sound of loud trumpet thundering along from heaven to heaven. A mighty sound, articulate, awake ye dead and come to judgment from the four winds, awake and come away. Folding like scrolls of the enormous volume of heaven and earth, with thunderous noise and dreadful shakings rocking to and fro. The heavens are shaken and the earth removed from its place. The foundations of the eternal hills discovered. The thrones of kings are shaken, they have lost their robes and crowns. The poor smite their oppressors, they awake up to the harvest. The naked warriors rush together down to the seashore, trembling before the multitudes of slaves now set at liberty. They are become like wintry flocks, like forests striped of leaves. The oppressed pursue like the wind, there is no room for escape. The specter of Enitherman let loose on the troubled deep wailed shrill in the confusion, and the specter of Earthena received her in the darkening south. Their bodies lost they stood, trembling and weak, a faint embrace of fierce desire, as when two shadows mingle on a wall, they wail, and shadowy tears fell down, and shadowy forms of joy mixed with despair and grief. Their bodies buried in the ruins of the universe, mingled with the confusion. Who shall call them from the grave? Rahab and Tirzah wail aloud in the wild flames, they give up themselves to consummation. The books of Urizen unroll with dreadful noise, the folding serpent of Ork began to consume in fierce raving fire his fierce flames. Isud on all sides gathering strength in animating volumes, roaming abroad on all the winds, raging intense reddening into resistless pillars of fire, rolling round and round gathering strength from the earth's consumed and heavens and all hidden abysses. Wherever the eagle has explored, or lion or tiger trod, or where the comets of the night or stars of Astri all day have shot their arrows or long-beamed spears in wrath and fury. And all the while the trumpet sounds from the clotted gore and from the hollow den start forth the trembling millions into flames of mental fire, bathing their limbs in the bright visions of eternity. Then like the doves from pillars of smoke, the trembling families of women and children throughout every nation under heaven cling round the men in bands of twenties and of fifties, pale as snow that falls around a leafless tree upon the green. Their oppressors are fallen, they have stricken them, they awake to life. Yet pale the just man stands erect and looking up to heaven, trembling and strucken by the universal stroke. The trees unroot, the rocks groan horrible and run about, the mountains end, their rivers cry with a dismal cry, the cattle gather together, lowing they kneel before the heavens. The wild beasts of the forests tremble, the lion shuddering asks the leopard, feelest thou the dread I feel unknown before my voice refuses to roar? And in weak moans I speak to thee this night. Before the morning's dawn the eagle called the vulture, the raven called the hawk, I heard them from my forests black, saying let us go up far, for soon I smell upon the wind a terror coming from the south. The eagle and hawk fled away at dawn, and ere the sun arose the raven and vulture followed. Let us flee also to the north. They fled. The sons of men saw them depart in dismal droves. The trumpet sounded loud, and all the sons of eternity descended into Beulah. In the fierce flames the limbs of mystery lay consuming with howling and deep despair. Rattling go up the flames around the synagogue of Satan, loud the serpent Ork ragged through his 27 folds. The tree of mystery went up in folding flames. Blood is sought out in mighty volumes, pouring in whirlpools fierce. From out the floodgates of the sky the gates are burst down pour. The torrents black upon the earth the blood pours down incessant. Kings in their palaces lie drowned, shepherds their flocks their tents. Roll down the mountains in black torrents cities villages. High spires and castles drowned in the black deluge shoal on shoal. Float the dead carcasses of men and beasts driven to and fro on waves. Of foaming blood beneath the black incessant sky till all. Mystery's tyrants are cut off and not one left on earth. And when all tyranny was cut off from the face of earth. Around the dragon form of Urizen and round his stony form. The flames rolling intense through the wide universe. Began to enter the holy city. Entraying the dismal clouds. In furrowed lightnings break their way the wild flames, whirling up. The bloody deluge living flames winged with intellect. And reason round the earth they march in order flame by flame. From the clotted gore and from the hollow den. Start forth the trembling millions into flames of mental fire. Bathing their limbs in the bright visions of eternity. Beyond this universal confusion, beyond the remotest pole. Where their vortexes begin to operate there stands. A horrible rock far in the south it was forsaken when. Urizen gave the horses of light into the hands of Lava. On this rock lay the faded head of the eternal man. Enwrapped round with weeds of death, pale cold in sorrow and woe. He lifts the blue lamps of his eyes and cries with heavenly voice. Bowing his head over the consuming universe he cried. O weakness and O weariness, O war within my members. My sons exiled from my breast pass to and fro before me. My birds are silent on my hills, flocks die beneath my branches. My tents are fallen, my trumpets and the sweet sounds of my harp. Is silent on my clouded hills that belch forth storms and fires. My milk of cows and honey of bees and fruit of golden harvest. Are gathered in the scorching heat and in the driving rain. My robe is turned to confusion and my bright gold to stones. Where once I sat. I weary walk in misery and pain. For from within my withered breast grown narrow with my woes. The corn is turned to thistles and the apples into poison. The birds of song to murderous crows, my joys to bitter groans. The voices of children in my tents to cries of helpless infants. And all exiled from the face of light and shine of morning. In this dark world a narrow house I wander up and down. I hear mystery howling in these flames of consummation. When shall the man of future times become as in days of old? O weary life, why sit I here and give up all my powers? To indolence, to the night of death when indolence and mourning sit hovering over my dark threshold. Though I arise, look out. And scorn the war within my members, yet my heart is weak. And my head faint, yet will I look again unto the morning. Whence is the sound of rage of men drinking each other's blood? Drunk with the smoking gore and red, but not with nourishing wine. The eternal man sat on the rocks and cried with awful voice. O Prince of Light, where art thou? I behold thee not as once. In those eternal fields in clouds of morning stepping forth. With harps and songs where bright Ahania sang before thy face. And all thy sons and daughters gathered round my ample table. See you not all this racking furious confusion? Come forth from slumbers of thy cold abstraction, come forth. Arise to eternal births, shake off thy cold repose. Schoolmaster of souls, great opposer of change, arise. That the eternal worlds may see thy face in peace and joy. That thou dread form of certainty mayest sit in town and village. While little children play around thy feet in gentle awe. Fearing thy frown, loving thy smile, O Urizen, Prince of Light. He called the deep, buried his voice, and answer none returned. Then wrath burst round the eternal man, was wrath again, he cried. Arise, O stony form of death, O dragon of the deeps. Lie down before my feet, O dragon, let Urizen arise. O how couldst thou deform those beautiful proportions of life and person, for as the person so is his life proportioned. Let love rage in the dark deep even to consummation. For if thou feedest not his rage it will subside in peace. But if thou darest obstinate refuse my stern behest. Thy crown and scepter I will seize and regulate all my members. In stern severity and cast thee out into the indefinite. Where nothing lives, there to wander. And if thou returnest weary, weeping at the threshold of existence I will steel my heart. Against thee to eternity and never receive thee more. Thy self-destroying beast-formed science shall be thy eternal lot. My anger against thee is greater than against this Silva. For war is energy enslaved but thy religion. The first author of this war and the distracting of honest minds. Into confused perturbation and strife and honor and pride. Is a deceit so detestable that I will cast thee out. If thou repentest not and leave thee as a rotten branch to be burned. With mystery the harlot and with Satan forever and ever. Error can never be redeemed in all eternity. But sin even Rahab is redeemed in blood and fury and jealousy. That line of blood that stretched across the windows of the morning. Redeemed from error's power. Wake thou dragon of the deeps. Urizen wept in the dark deep anxious his scaly form. To reassume the human and he wept in the dark deep. Saying oh that I had never drank the wine nor eat the bread. Of dark mortality nor cast my view into the futurity nor turned. My back darkening the present clouding with a cloud. And building arches high and cities turrets and towers and domes. Whose smoke destroyed the pleasant garden and whose running kennels. Chalked the bright rivers burdening with my ships the angry deep. Through chaos seeking for delight and in spaces remote. Seeking the eternal which is always present to the wise. Seeking for pleasure which unsought falls round the infant's path. And on the fleeces of mild flocks who neither care nor labor. But I the laborer of ages whose unwearied hands are thus deformed with hardness with the sword and with the spear. And with the chisel and the mallet I whose labor's vest. Order the nations separating family by family. Alone enjoy not. I alone in misery supreme. Ungratified give all my joy unto this Silva and Vala. Then go O dark futurity I will cast thee forth from these. Heavens of my brain nor will I look upon futurity more. I cast futurity away and turn my back upon that void. Which I have made for low futurity is in this moment. Let orc consume let thermas rage let dark earthena give. All strength to los and enitherman and let los self cursed. Rend down this fabric as a wall ruined and family extinct. Rage orc rage thermas urizen no longer curbs your rage. So urizen spoke he shook his snows from off his shoulders and arose. As on a pyramid of mist his white robes scattering. The fleecy white renewed he shook his aged mantles off. Into the fires then glorious bright exulting in his joy. He sounding rose into the heavens in naked majesty. In radiant youth. When low like garlands in the eastern sky. When vocal May comes dancing from the east Ahania came. Exulting in her flight as when a bubble rises up. Onto the surface of a lake. Ahania rose in joy. Excess of joy is worse than grief her heart beat high her blood. Burst its bright vessels she fell down dead at the feet of Urizen. Outstretched a smiling corse they buried her in a silent cave. Urizen dropped a tear the eternal man darkened with sorrow. The three daughters of Urizen guard Ahania's death couch. Rising from the confusion in tears and howlings and despair. Calling upon their father's name upon their rivers dark. And the eternal man said hear my words O Prince of Light. Behold Jerusalem in whose bosom the Lamb of God. Is seen though slain before her gates he self renewed remains. Eternal and I threw him awake from death's dark veil. The times revolve the time is coming when all these delights. Shall be renewed and all these elements that now consume. Shall reflourish. Then bright Ahania shall awake from death. A glorious vision to thine eyes a self-renewing vision. The spring. The summer to be thine then sleep the wintry days. In silken garments spun by her own hands against her funeral. The winter thou shalt plow and lay thy stores into thy barns. Expecting to receive Ahania in the spring with joy. Immortal thou. Regenerate she and all the lovely sex. From her shall learn obedience and prepare for a wintry grave. That spring may see them rise in tenfold joy and sweet delight. Thus shall the male and female live the life of eternity. Because the Lamb of God creates himself a bride and wife, that we his children evermore may live in Jerusalem, which now descendeth out of heaven a city yet a woman, mother of myriads redeemed and born in her spiritual palaces, by a new spiritual birth regenerated from death. Urizen said, I have erred and my error remains with me. What chain encompasses in what lock is the river of light confined? That issues forth in the morning by measure and the evening by carefulness. Where shall we take our stand to view the infinite and unbounded? Or where our human feet, for lo our eyes are in the heavens. He ceased for riven link from link the bursting universe explodes. All things reversed flew from their centers rattling bones. To bones join, shaking convulsed the shivering clay breathes. Each speck of dust to the earth center nestles round and round. In pangs of an eternal birth in torment and awe and fear. All spirits deceased let loose from reptile prisons come in shoals. Wild furies from the tiger's brain and from the lion's eyes. And from the ox and ass come moping terrors. From the eagle. And raven numerous as the leaves of autumn every species. Flock to the trumpet muttering over the sides of the grave and crying. In the fierce wind round heaving rocks and mountains filled with groans. On ripped rocks suspended in the air by inward fires. Many a woeful company and many on clouds and waters. Fathers and friends, mothers and infants, kings and warriors. Priests and chained captives met together in a horrible fear. And every one of the dead appears as he had looked before. And all the marks remain of the slave's scourge and tyrant's crown. And of the priest's urgurged abdomen and of the merchant's thin. Sinewy deception and of the warrior's outbraving and thoughtlessness. In lineaments too extended and in bones too straight and long. They shew their wounds, they accuse, they seize the oppressor. Howlings began. On the golden palace songs and joy on the desart the cold babe. Stands in the furious air he cries the children of 6,000 years. Who died in infancy rage furious a mighty multitude rage furious. Naked and pale standing on the expecting air to be delivered. Rend limb from limb the warrior and the tyrant reuniting in pain. The furious wind still rends around they flee in sluggish effort. They beg they entreat in vain now they listened not to intred. They view the flames red rolling on through the wide universe. From the dark jaws of death beneath and desolate shores remote. These covering vaults of heaven and these trembling globes of earth. One planet calls to another and one star inquires of another. What flames are these coming from the south? What noise? What dreadful rout? As of a battle in the heavens hark, heard you not the trumpet? As of fierce battle while they spoke the flames come on intense roaring. They see him whom they have pierced, they wail because of him. They magnify themselves no more against Jerusalem nor against her little ones the innocent accused before the judges. Shines with immortal glory trembling the judge springs from his throne. Hiding his face in the dust beneath the prisoner's feet and saying. Brother of Jesus, what have I done? Entreat thy Lord for me. Perhaps I may be forgiven. While he speaks the flames roll on. And after the flames appears the cloud of the Son of Man. Descending from Jerusalem with power and great glory. All nations look up to the cloud and behold him who was crucified. The prisoner answers, you scourged my father to death before my face. While I stood bound with cords and heavy chains. Your hypocrisy shall now avail you not. So speaking he dashed him with his foot. The cloud is blood dazzling upon the heavens and in the cloud. Above upon its volumes is beheld a throne and a pavement of precious stones. Surrounded by 24 venerable patriarchs. And these again surrounded by 4 wonders of the Almighty. Incomprehensible. Pervading all amidst and round about. Fourfold each in the other reflected they are named lives in eternity. 4 starry universes going forward from eternity to eternity. And the fallen man who was arisen upon the rock of ages. Beheld the vision of God and he arose up from the rock. And Urizen arose up with him walking through the flames. To meet the Lord coming to judgment but the flames repelled them. Still to the rock in vain they strove to enter the consummation. Together for the redeemed man could not enter the consummation. Then seized the sons of Urizen the plough they polished it. from rust of ages all its ornaments of gold and silver and ivory. Rishoni across the field immense where all the nations. Darkened like mold in the divided fallows where the weed. Triumphs in its own destruction they took down the harness. From the blue walls of heaven starry jingling ornamented. With beautiful art the study of angels the workmanship of demons. When heaven and hell in emulation strove in sports of glory. The noise of rural work resounded through the heavens of heavens. The horses neigh from the battle, the wild bulls from the sultry waste. The tigers from the forests and the lions from the sandy deserts. They sing, they seize the instruments of harmony they throw away. The spear, the bow, the gun, the mortar, they level the fortifications. They beat the iron engines of destruction into wedges. They give them to earthenous sons ringing the hammer's sound. In dens of death to forge the spade, the mattock and the axe. The heavy roller to break the clods to pass over the nations. The sons of Urizen shout, their father rose, the eternal horses. Harnessed they called to Urizen, the heavens moved at their call. The limbs of Urizen shone with ardor. He laid his hand on the plow. Through dismal darkness drave the plow of ages over cities. And all their villages over mountains and all their valleys. Over the graves and caverns of the dead. Over the planets. And over the void spaces, over sun and moon and star and constellation. Then Urizen commanded and they brought the seed of men. The trembling souls of all the dead stood before Urizen. Weak wailing in the troubled air east, west and north and south. He turned the horses loose and laid his plow in the northern corner. Of the wide universal field. Then stepped forth into the immense. Then he began to sow the seed he girded round his loins. With a bright girdle and his skirt filled with immortal souls. Howling and wailing fly the souls from Urizen's strong hand. For from the hand of Urizen the myriads fall like stars. Into their own appointed places driven back by the winds. The naked warriors rush together down to the seashores. They are become like wintry flocks, like forests striped of leaves. The kings and princes of the earth cry with a feeble cry. Driven on the unproducing sands and on the hard-end rocks. And all the while the flames of Orc follow the vent rouse feet. Of Urizen, and all the while the trump of Thermus sounds. Weeping and wailing fly the souls from Urizen's strong hand. The daughters of Urizen stand with cups and measures of foaming wine. Immense upon the heavens with bread and delicate repasts. Then follows the golden harrow in the midst of mental fires. To ravishing melody of flutes and harps and softest voice. The seed is harrowed in while flames heat the black mold and cause. The human harvest to begin towards the south first sprang. The myriads and in silent fear they look out from their graves. Then Urizen sits down to rest and all his wearied sons. Take their repose on beds, they drink, they sing, they view the flames. Of Orc in joy they view the human harvest springing up. A time they give to sweet repose till all the harvest is ripe. And lo, like the harvest moon Ahania cast off her death clothes. She folded them up in care in silence and her brightening limbs. Bathed in the clear spring of the rock then from her darksome cave. Issud in majesty divine. Urizen rose up from his couch. On wings of tenfold joy clapping his hands his feet his radiant wings. In the immense as when the sun dances upon the mountains. A shout of jubilee in lovely notes responding from daughter to daughter. From sun to sun as if the stars beaming innumerable. Through night should sing soft warbling filling earth and heaven. And bright Ahania took her seat by Urizen in songs and joy. The eternal man also sat down upon the couches of Beulah. Sorrowful that he could not put off his new risen body. In mental flames the flames refuzzed they drove him back to Beulah. His body was redeemed to be permanent through mercy divine. And now fierce Orc had quite consumed himself in mental flames. Expending all his energy against the fuel of fire. The regenerate man stooked his head over the universe and in. His holy hands received the flaming demon and demoness of smoke. And gave them to Urizen's hands the immortal frown saying. Lava and Vala, henceforth you are servants, obey and live. You shall forget your former state, return O love in peace. Into your place the place of seed, not in the brain or heart. If gods combine against man setting their dominion above. the human form divine, thrown down from their high station, in the eternal heavens of human imagination, buried beneath, in dark oblivion with incessant pangs ages on ages, in enmity and war first weekend then in stern repentance. They must renew their brightness and their disorganized functions. Again reorganize till they resume the image of the human. Cooperating in the bliss of man obeying his will. Servants to the infinite and eternal of the human form. Lava and Vala descended and entered the gates of dark Earthana, and walked from the hands of Urizen in the shadows of Vala's garden, where the impressions of despair and hope forever vegetate. In flowers, in fruits, in fishes, birds and beasts and clouds and waters. The land of doubts and shadows, sweet delusions, unformed hopes. They saw no more the terrible confusion of the racking universe. They heard not, saw not, felt not all the terrible confusion. For in their orbed senses within closhed up they wandered at will. And those upon the couches viewed them in the dreams of Beulah, as they reapest from the terrible wide universal harvest. Invisible lava in bright clouds hovered over Vala's head. And thus their ancient golden age renewed, for lava spoke, with voice mild from his golden cloud upon the breath of morning. Come forth, O Vala, from the grass and from the silent dew. Rise from the dews of death, for the eternal man is risen. She rises among flowers and looks toward the eastern clearness. She walks, she runs, her feet are winged on the tops of the bending grass. Her garments rejoice in the vocal wind and her hair glistens with dew. She answered thus, whose voice is this in the voice of the nourishing air? In the spirit of the morning awaking the soul from its grassy bed. Where dost thou dwell, for it is thee I seek, and but for thee? I must have slept eternally nor have felt the dew of thy morning. Look how the opening dawn advances with vocal harmony. Look how the beams foreshew the rising of some glorious power. The sun is thine. He goeth forth in his majestic brightness. O thou creating voice that cayest, and who shall answer thee? Where dost thou flee, O fair one, where dost thou seek thy happy place? To yonder brightness there I haste, for sure I came from thence. Or I must have slept eternally nor have felt the dew of morning. Eternally thou must have slept nor have felt the morning dew. But for yon nourishing sun 'tis that by which thou art arisen. The birds adore the sun, the beasts rise up and play in his beams. And every flower and every leaf rejoices in his light. Then, O thou fair one, sit thee down, for thou art as the grass. Thou risest in the dew of morning and at night art folded up. Alas, am I but as a flower, then will I sit me down. Then will I weep, then ill complain and sigh for immortality. And chide my maker thee, O sun, that raisedst me to fall. So saying she sat down and wept beneath the apple trees. O be thou blotted out, thou sun that raisedst me to trouble. That gavest me a heart to crave and raisedst me thy phantom. To feel thy heat and see thy light and wander here alone. Hopeless if I am like the grass and so shall pass away. Rise, sluggish soul, why sitst thou here, why dost thou sit and weep? Yon sun shall wax old and decay, but thou shalt ever flourish. The fruit shall ripen and fall down and the flowers consume away. But thou shalt still survive, arise, O dry thy dewy tears. Ha! Shall I still survive, whence came that sweet and comforting voice? And whence that voice of sorrow, O sun, thou art nothing now to me. Go on thy course rejoicing and let us both rejoice together. I walk among his flocks and hear the bleating of his lambs. O that I could behold his face and follow his pure feet. I walk by the footsteps of his flocks, come hither tender flocks. Can you converse with a pure soul that seeketh for her maker? You answer not, then am I set your mistress in this garden. Ill watch you and attend your footsteps, you are not like the birds that sing and fly in the bright air, but you do lick my feet. And let me touch your woolly backs, follow me as I sing. For in my bosom a new song arises to my Lord. Rise up, O sun, most glorious minister and light of day. Flow on, ye gentle airs, and bear the voice of my rejoicing. Wave freshly clear waters flowing around the tender grass. And thou sweet-smelling ground, put forth thy life in fruits and flowers. Follow me, O my flocks, and hear me sing my rapturous song. I will cause my voice to be heard on the clouds that glitter in the sun. I will call, and who shall answer me? I will sing, who shall reply? For from my pleasant hills behold the living, living springs. Running among my green pastures, delighting among my trees. I am not here alone, my flocks, you are my brethren. And you birds that sing and adorn the sky, you are my sisters. I sing and you reply to my song, I rejoice and you are glad. Follow me, O my flocks, we will now descend into the valley. Oh, how delicious are the grapes flourishing in the sun! How clear the spring of the rock running among the golden sand! How cool the breezes of the valley and the arms of the branching trees! Cover us from the sun, come and let us sit in the shade. My lover here hath placked me in a sweet and pleasant land, and given me fruits and pleasant waters and warm hills and cool valleys. Here will I build myself a house, and here I'll call on his name. Here I'll return when I am weary and take my pleasant rest. So spoke the sinless soul and laid her head on the downy fleece of a curled ram, who stretched himself in sleep beside his mistress. And soft sleep fell upon her eyelids in the silent noon of day. Then Lava passed by and saw the sinless soul, and said, let a pleasant house arise to be the dwelling place of this immortal spirit growing in lower paradise. He spoke and pillars were builded and walls as white as ivory. The grass she slept upon was paved with pavement as a pearl. Beneath her rose a downy bed and a ceiling covered all. Vala awoke. When in the pleasant gates of sleep I entered, I saw my lover like a spirit stand in the bright air. Round him stood spirits like me who reared me a bright house. And here I see thee house remain in my most pleasant world. My lover smiled, I kneeled down, he laid his hand on my head. And when he laid his hand upon me, from the gates of sleep I came into this bodily house to tend my flocks in my pleasant garden. So saying she arose and walked round her beautiful house. And then from her white door she looked to see her bleeding lambs. But her flocks were gone up from beneath the trees into the hills. I see the hand that leadeth me doth also lead my flocks. She went up to her flocks and turned off to see her shining house. She stopped to drink of the clear spring and eat the grapes and apples. She bore the fruits in her lap, she gathered flowers for her bosom. She called to her flocks saying, follow me, O my flocks. They followed her to the silent valley beneath the spreading trees. And on the river's margin she ungirded her golden girdle. She stood in the river and viewed herself within the watery glass. And her bright hair was wet with the waters, she rose up from the river. And as she rose her eyes were open to the world of waters. She saw Therma sitting upon the rocks beside the wavy sea. He stroked the water from his beard and mourned faint through the summer veils. And Vala stood on the rocks of Therma's and heard his mournful voice. O Enyan, my weary head is in the bed of death. Four weeds of death have wrapped around my limbs in the hoary deeps. I sit in the place of shells and mourn, and thou art closhed in clouds. When will the time of clouds be past and the dismal night of Therma's? Arise, O Enyan, arise and smile upon my head. As thou dost smile upon the barren mountains and they rejoice. When wilt thou smile on Therma's, O thou bringer of golden day? Arise, O Enyan, arise, for lo, I have calmed my seas. So saying his faint head he laid upon the oozy rock. And darkness covered all the deep, the light of Enyan faded. Like a faint flame quivering upon the surface of the darkness. Then Vala lifted up her hands to heaven to call on Enyan. She called but none could answer her, and the echo of her voice returned. Where is the voice of God that called me from the silent dew? Where is the Lord of Vala? Dost thou hide in clefts of the rock? Why shouldst thou hide thyself from Vala, from the soul that wanders desolate? She ceased and light beamed round her like the glory of the morning. And she arose out of the river and girded her golden girdle. And now her feet step on the grassy bosom of the ground. Among her flocks, and she turned her eyes toward her pleasant house. And saw in the doorway beneath the trees two little children playing. She drew near to her house and her flocks followed her footsteps. The children clung around her knees, she embraced them and wept over them. Thou little boy art Therma's, and thou bright girl Enyan. How are ye thus renewed and brought into the gardens of Vala? She embraced them in tears. Till the sun descended the western hills. And then she entered her bright house leading her mighty children. And when night came the flocks laid round the house beneath the trees. She laid the children on the beds which she saw prepared in the house. Then last herself laid down and closed her eyelids in soft slumbers. And in the morning when the sun arose in the crystal sky, Vala awoke and called the children from their gentle slumbers. Awake, O Enyan, awake and let thine innocent eyes enlighten all the crystal house of Vala. Awake, awake. Awake, Thermas, awake, awake, thou child of dewy tears. Open the orbs of thy blue eyes and smile upon my gardens. The children woke and smiled on Vala. She kneeled by the golden couch. She pressed them to her bosom and her pearly tears dropped down. O my sweet children, Enyan, let Thermas kiss thy cheek. Why dost thou turn thyself away from his sweet watery eyes? Thermas, henceforth in Vala's bosom thou shalt find sweet peace. O bless the lovely eyes of Thermas and the eyes of Enyan. They rose, they went out wandering, sometimes together, sometimes alone. Why weepest thou, Thermas, child of tears, in the bright house of joy? Doth Enyan avoid the sight of thy blue heavenly eyes? And dost thou wander with my lambs and wet their innocent faces with thy bright tears because the steps of Enyan are in the gardens? Arise, sweet boy, and let us follow the path of Enyan. So saying, they went down into the garden among the fruits. And Enyan sang among the flowers that grew among the trees. And Vala said, Go, Thermas, weep not, go to Enyan. He said, O Vala, I am sick, and all this garden of pleasure swims like a dream before my eyes, but the sweet-smelling fruit revives me to new deaths. I fade even like a water lily in the sun's heat, till in the night on the couch of Enyan I drink new life and feel the breath of sleeping Enyan. But in the morning she arises to avoid my eyes. Then my loins fade, and in the house I sit me down and weep. Cheer up thy countenance, bright boy, and go to Enyan. Tell her that Vala waits her in the shadows of her garden. He went with timid steps, and Enyan, like the ruddy morn when infant spring appears in swelling buds and opening flowers, behind her veil withdraws. So Enyan turned her modest head. But Thermas spoke, Vala seeks thee, sweet Enyan, in the shades. Follow the steps of Thermas, O thou brightness of the gardens. He took her hand reluctant, she followed in infant doubts. Thus in eternal childhood straying among Vala's flocks, in infant sorrow and joy alternate Enyan and Thermas played round Vala in the gardens of Vala and by her river's margin. They are the shadows of Thermas and of Enyan in Vala's world. And the sleepers who rested from their harvest work beheld these visions. Thus were the sleepers entertained upon the couches of Beulah, when Lava and Vala were closed up in their world of shadowy forms. Darkness was all beneath the heavens, only a little light, such as glows out from sleeping spirits, appeared in the deeps beneath. As when the wind sweeps over a cornfield, the noise of souls through all the immense, borne down by clouds swagging in autumnal heat, muttering along from heaven to heaven, hoarse roll the human forms. Beneath thick clouds dreadful lightnings burst and thunders roll. Down pour the torrent floods of heaven on all the human harvest. Then Urizen, sitting at his repose on beds in the bright south, cried, times are ended. He exulted, he arose in joy, he exulted. He poured his light, and all his sons and daughters poured their light to exhale the spirits of Lava and Vala through the atmosphere. And Lava and Vala saw the light, their spirits were exhaled. In all their ancient innocence the floods depart, the clouds dissipate or sink into the seas of Thermas. Lava sat above on the bright heavens in peace. The spirits of men beneath cried out to be delivered, and the spirit of Lava wept over the human harvest and over Vala the sweet wanderer. In pain the human harvest wept in horrible groans of woe. The universal groan went up, the eternal man was darkened. Then Urizen arose and took his sickle in his hand. There is a brazen sickle and a scythe of iron hid deep in the south, guarded by a few solitary stars. This sickle Urizen took, the scythe his sons embraced, and went forth and began to reap, and all his joyful sons reaped the wide universe and bound in sheaves a wondrous harvest. They took them into the wide barns with loud rejoicings and triumph of flute and harp and drum and trumpet, horn and clarion. The feast was spread in the bright south, and the regenerate man sat at the feast rejoicing, and the wine of eternity was served round by the flames of Lava all day and all the night. And when morning began to dawn upon the distant hills, a whirlwind rose up in the center, and in the whirlwind a shriek. And in the shriek a rattling of bones, and in the rattling of bones a dolorous groan, and from the dolorous groan in tears rose Enyan like a gentle light. And Enyan spoke, saying, O dreams of death, the human form dissolving, companied by beasts and worms and creeping things and darkness and despair. The clouds fall off from my wet brow, the dust from my cold limbs. Into the sea of Therma soon renewed a golden moth. I shall cast off my death clothes and embrace Thermas again. For lo, the winter melted away upon the distant hills. And all the black mold sings. She speaks to her infant race, her milk descends down on the sand. The thirsty sand drinks and rejoices, wondering to behold the emmet, the grasshopper, the jointed worm. The roots shoot thick through the solid rocks, bursting their way. They cry out in joys of existence. The broad stems rear on the mountain, stem after stem the scaly newt creeps from the stone, and the armed fly springs from the rocky crevice. The spider, the bat burst from the hard end slime, crying to one another, what are we and whence is our joy and delight? Lo, the little moss begins to spring, and the tender weed creeps round our secret nest. Flocks brighten the mountains. Herds throng up the valley, wild beasts fill the forests. Joy thrilled through all the furious form of Therma's humanizing. Mild he embraced her whom he sought, he raised her through the heavens. Sounding his trumpet to awake the dead on high, he soared over the ruined worlds, the smoking tomb of the eternal prophet. The eternal man arose, he welcomed them to the feast. The feast was spread in the bright south, and the eternal man sat at the feast rejoicing, and the wine of eternity was served round by the flames of lava all day and all the night. And many eternal men sat at the golden feast to see the female form now separate. They shuddered at the horrible thing, not born for the sport and amusement of man, but born to drink up all his powers. They wept to see their shadows. They said to one another, this is sin. This is the generative world. They remembered the days of old. And one of the eternals spoke, all was silent at the feast. Man is a worm wearied with joy, he seeks the caves of sleep. Among the flowers of Beulah in his selfish cold repose. Forsaking brotherhood and universal love in selfish clay. Folding the pure wings of his mind, seeking the places dark. Abstracted from the roots of science, then encloshed around. In walls of gold we cast him like a seed into the earth. Till times and spaces have passed over him duly every morn. We visit him covering with a veil the immortal seed. With windows from the inclement sky we cover him, and with walls and hearths protect the selfish terror till divided all. In families we see our shadows born. And thence we know that man subsists by brotherhood and universal love. We fall on one another's necks, more closely we embrace. Not for ourselves but for the eternal family we live. Man liveth not by self alone but in his brother's face. Each shall behold the eternal father, and love and joy abound. So spoke the eternal at the feast. They embraced the newborn man, calling him brother, image of the eternal father. They sat down at the immortal table, sounding loud their instruments of joy. Calling the morning into Beulah, the eternal man rejoiced. When morning dawned, the eternals rose to labor at the vintage. Beneath they saw their sons and daughters wondering inconceivable at the dark myriads in shadows in the worlds beneath. The morning dawned, Urizen rose, and in his hand the flail. Sounds on the floor heard terrible by all beneath the heavens. Dismal loud redounding the nether floor shakes with the sound. And all nations were threshed out, and the stars threshed from their husks. Then Thermas took the winnowing fan, the winnowing wind furious. Above veered round by the violent whirlwind driven west and south. Tossed the nations like chaff into the seas of Thermas. O mystery fierce, Thermas cries, behold thy end is come. Art thou she that made the nations drunk with the cup of religion? Go down, ye kings and counselors and giant warriors. Go down into the depths, go down and hide yourselves beneath. Go down with horse and chariots and trumpets of horse war. Lo, how the pomp of mystery goes down into the caves. Her great men howl and throw the dust and rend their hoary hair. Her delicate women and children shriek upon the bitter wind. Spoiled of their beauty, their hair rent and their skin shrivelled up. Low darkness covers the long pomp of banners on the wind. And black horses and armed men and miserable bound captives. Where shall the graves receive them all, and where shall be their place? And who shall mourn for mystery who never loosed her captives? Let the slave grinding at the mill run out into the field. Let him look up into the heavens and laugh in the bright air. Let the enchained soul shut up in darkness and in sighing. Whose face has never seen a smile in 30 weary years. Rise and look out, his chains are loose, his dungeon doors are open. And let his wife and children return from the oppressor's scourge. They look behind at every step and believe it is a dream. Are these the slaves that groaned along the streets of mystery? Where are your bonds and taskmasters? Are these the prisoners? Where are your chains? Where are your tears? Why do you look around? If you are thirsty, there is the river, go bathe your parched limbs. The good of all the land is before you, for mystery is no more. Then all the slaves from every earth in the wide universe sing a new song, drowning confusion in its happy notes. While the flail of Urizen sounded long and the winnowing wind of Thermas so loud, so clear in the wide heavens, and the song that they sung was this. Composed by an African black from the little earth of Sutha. Aha, aha, how came I here so soon in my sweet native land? How came I here? Methinks I am as I was in my youth. When in my father's house I sat and heard his cheering voice. Methinks I see his flocks and herds and feel my limbs renewed. And lo, my brethren in their tents and their little ones around them. The song arose to the golden feast, the eternal man rejoiced. Then the eternal man said, Lova, the vintage is ripe, arise. The sons of Urizen shall gather the vintage with sharp hooks. And all thy sons, O Lova, bear away the families of earth. I hear the flail of Urizen, his barns are full, no room remains, and in the vineyards stand the abounding sheaves beneath. The falling grapes that odorous burst upon the winds. Arise. My flocks and herds trample the corn my cattle browse upon. The ripe clusters the shepherds shout for Lova, prince of love. Let the bulls of Lova tread the corn and draw the loaded wagon into the barn, while children glean the ears around the door. Then shall they lift their innocent hands and stroke his furious nose. And he shall lick the little girl's white neck and on her head scatter the perfume of his breath, while from his mountains high the lion of terror shall come down and bending his bright mane and couching at their side shall eat from the curled boy's white lap his golden food, and in the evening sleep before the door. Attempting to be more than man, we become less, said Lova. As he arose from the bright feast drunk with the wine of ages, his crown of thorns fell from his head, he hung his living lyre behind the seat of the eternal man and took his way, sounding the song of Los descending to the vineyards bright. His sons arising from the feast with golden baskets follow a fiery train, as when the sun sings in the ripe vineyards. Then Lova stood before the winepress, all his fiery sons brought up the loaded wagons with shoutings, ramping tigers play in the jingling traces, furious lions sound the song of joy to the golden wheel circling upon the pavement of heaven, and all the villages of Lova ring the golden tiles of the villages reply to violins and tabors, to the pipe, flute, lyre and cymbal. Then fell the legions of mystery in maddening confusion down, down through the immense without cry, fury and despair. Into the wine presses of Lova howling fell the clusters of human families through the deep. The wine presses were filled. The blood of life flowed, plentiful odors of life arose all round the heavenly arches, and the odors rose singing this song. O terrible wine presses of Lova, O caverns of the grave. How lovely the delights of those risen again from death. O trembling joy, excess of joy is like excess of grief. So sang the human odors round the wine presses of Lova. But in the wine presses is wailing terror and despair. Forsaken of their elements, they vanish and are no more. No more but a desire of being, a distracted ravening desire. Desiring like the hungry worm and like the gaping grave. They plunge into the elements cast them forth. Or else consume their shadowy semblance, yet they obstinate. Though pain to distraction cry, O let us exist, for This dreadful non-existence is worse than pains of eternal birth. Eternal death who can endure? Let us consume in fires, in waters stifling or in air corroding or in earth shut up. The pangs of eternal birth are better than the pangs of eternal death. How red the sons and daughters of Lava, how they tread the grapes. Laughing and shouting drunk with odors many fall air wearied. Drowned in the wine is many a youth and maiden those around. Lay them on skins of tigers or the spotted leopard or wild ass. Till they revive or bury them in cool grots making lamentation. But in the wine presses the human grapes sing not nor dance. They howl and writhe in shoals of torment in fierce flames consuming. In chains of iron and in dungeons circled with ceaseless fires. In pits and dens and shades of death in shapes of torment and woe. The plates, the screws and racks and saws and cords and fires and floods. The cruel joy of Lava's daughters lacerating with knives. And whip their victims and the deadly sports of Lava's sons. Timbrels and violins sport round the wine presses the little seed. The sportive root, the earthworm, the small beetle, the wise emmet. Dance round the wine presses of Lava. The centipede is there. The ground spider with many eyes, the mole clothed in velvet. The earwig armed, the tender maggot, emblem of immortality. The slow slug, the grasshopper that sings and laughs and drinks. The winter comes, he folds his slender bones without a murmur. There is the nettle that stings with soft down, and there. The indignant thistle whose bitterness is bred in his milk. And who lives on the contempt of his neighbor, there all the idle weeds. That creep about the obscure places shew their various limbs. Naked in all their beauty dancing round the wine presses. They dance around the dying and they drink the howl and groan. They catch the shrieks in cups of gold, they hand them to one another. These are the sports of love and these the sweet delights of amorous play. Tears of the grapes, the death sweat of the cluster, the last sigh. Of the mild youth who listens to the luring songs of Lava. The eternal man darkened with sorrow and a wintry mantle. Covered the hills, he said, O Thermas rise and O Earthana. Then Thermas and Earthana rose from the golden feast satiated. With mirth and joy Earthana limping from his fall on Thermas leaned. In his right hand his hammer Thermas held his shepherd's crook. Beset with gold, gold were the ornaments formed by sons of Urizen. Then Enyan and Ahania and Vala and the wife of dark Earthana. Rose from the feast in joy ascending to their golden looms. There the winged shuttle sang, the spindle and the distaff and the reel. Rang sweet the praise of industry. Through all the golden rooms. Heaven rang with winged exultation, all beneath howled loud. With tenfold rout and desolation roared the chasms beneath. Where the wide woof flowed down and where the nations are gathered together. Thermas went down to the wine presses and beheld the sons and daughters. Of Lava quite exhausted with the labor and quite filled. With new wine. That they began to torment one another and to tread. The weak. Lava and Vala slept on the floor o'er wearied. Earthana called his sons around him, Thermas called his sons. Numerous. They took the wine, they separated the lees. And Lava was put for dung on the ground by the sons of Thermas and Earthana. They formed heavens of sweetest wood, of gold and silver and ivory. Of glass and precious stones they loaded all the wagons of heaven. And took away the wine of ages with solemn songs and joy. Lava and Vala woke, and all the sons and daughters of Lava. Awoke, they wept to one another and they reascended. To the eternal man in woe he cast them wailing into. The world of shadows through the air till winter is over and gone. But the human wine stood wondering in all their delightful expanses. The elements subside, the heavens rolled on with vocal harmony. Then Los, who is earth, and arose in all his regenerate power. The sea that rolled and foamed with darkness and the shadows of death. Vomited out and gave up all the floods, lift up their hands. Singing and shouting to the man they bow their hoary heads. And murmuring in their channels flow and circle round his feet. Then dark Earthana took the corn out of the stores of Urizen. He ground it in his rumbling mills, terrible the distress. Of all the nations of earth ground in the mills of Earthana. In his hand Thermas takes the storms. He turns the whirlwind loose. Upon the wheels the stormy seas howl at his dread command. And eddying fierce rejoice in the fierce agitation of the wheels. Of dark earth and thunders, earthquakes, fires, water floods. Rejoice to one another loud, their voices shake the abyss. Their dread forms tending the dire mills, the gray hoarfrost was there. And his pale wife the aged snow, they watch over the fires. They build the ovens of earth and nature in darkness groans. And men are bound to sullen contemplations in the night. Restless they turn on beds of sorrow. In their inmost brain. Feeling the crushing wheels they rise, they write the bitter words. Of stern philosophy and knead the bread of knowledge with tears and groans. Such are the works of dark earth and Therma sifted the corn. Earth and made the bread of ages and he placed it. In golden and in silver baskets in heavens of precious stone. And then took his repose in winter in the night of time. The sun has left his blackness and has found a fresher morning. And the mild moon rejoices in the clear and cloudless night. And man walks forth from midst of the fires, the evil is all consumed. His eyes behold the angelic spheres arising night and day. The stars consumed like a lamp blown out, and in their stead behold. The expanding eyes of man behold the depths of wondrous worlds. One earth, one sea beneath, nor erring globes wander but stars. Of fire rise up nightly from the ocean and one sun. Each morning like a newborn man issues with songs and joy. Calling the plowman to his labor and the shepherd to his rest. He walks upon the eternal mountains raising his heavenly voice. Conversing with the animal forms of wisdom night and day. That risen from the sea of fire renewed walk over the earth. For Thermas brought his flocks upon the hills and in the vales. Around the eternal man's bright tent the little children play. Among the woolly flocks the hammer of Earthana sounds. In the deep caves beneath his limbs renewed his lion's roar. Around the furnaces and in the evening sport upon the plains. They raise their faces from the earth conversing with the man. How is it we have walked through fires and yet are not consumed? How is it that all things are changed even as in ancient times? The sun arises from his dewy bed and the fresh airs. Play in his smiling beams giving the seeds of life to grow. And the fresh earth beams forth 10,000,000 springs of life. Earthana is arisen in his strength no longer now. Divided from Enitherman no longer the specter Los. Where is the specter of prophecy, where the delusive phantom? Departed and Earthana rises from the ruinous walls. In all his ancient strength to form the golden armor of science. For intellectual war the war of swords departed now. The dark religions are departed and sweet science reigns. End of night, the ninth and the last judgment.